Hi Aries, this is your December mid-month tarot reading. I do three separate spreads in my mid-month readings. We'll have a spread on new love, a separate spread on love in an existing relationship or marriage, and I'll do a love from the past spread. Please like, share, and subscribe to support this channel. This first spread is on new love in the second half of December. We have the King of Swords, we have the Sun, we have the Magician clarified by the Fool. In the potential outcome, we have the Empress with the Chariot and the World, and we also have the Queen of Swords on the bottom of the deck. You could be dealing with an air sign, Gemini, Libra, or Aquarius. You could also be dealing with Cancer. You see what I'm seeing here? We do have the King of Swords and the Queen of Swords, and every single remaining card on the table is a major arcana card. This is crazy. So we do have you as a power couple, right? And whoever this person is, you know, it's going to be your, first of all, it's going to be your happy end, because we have the World right next to the deck, and for some of you, you could be literally conquering the world. But hopefully you'll be doing it with love, happiness, and care, because we have the Empress on the table, and we have the Sun on the table. Right? The Sun is the happiest card in the deck, and the Empress is one of the most positive cards in the deck. So either way, like I said, yeah, the two of you are definitely starting this journey. It does look like a lifetime journey, seriously, and you can make anything happen, because like I said, the King and the Queen of Swords, you make a perfect power couple, right? Granted, the person you are dealing with could be an air sign, Gemini, Libra, or Aquarius, but they could be any sign. What's important is that the two of you vibe on the same level, the two of you have common goals, you have common interests, you're moving towards the same thing, right? And you are moving towards something, because we do have quite a few cards symbolizing new beginnings, new chapters, right? So as already mentioned, the Sun right next to the King of Swords is the happiest card in the deck. It's also all about clarity, so if you're crystal clear about this person's intentions, about the direction the two of you are moving, right? Then we have the Magician with the Fool. So the Magician is a card, major arcana number one, but the Fool is the major arcana number zero. Both cards are brand new beginnings. The Magician is a card of action, and so is the Fool. The Fool is a brand new beginning with this person, and it's like, since you have this instant connection, instant chemistry, instant understanding that the two of you can make anything happen, you're taking that leap of faith with the Fool, and you're not looking back. It'll be a super easy decision for you, right? In the potential outcome, we have the Empress with the Chariot and the World. As I already mentioned, the Empress is one of the most positive cards in the deck. That's the way this person sees you, right? They do see you as somebody they want to spend the rest of their life with. They're putting you up on a pedestal. The Empress sometimes comes through as somebody who is expecting a baby. So if having children is still an option for you, the two of you could definitely have children together. But other than that, the Empress is simply abundance in its purest form. In my spreads, the Empress usually shows up as a sign from above, or like a stamp of approval, so to speak, from the universe for a connection to move forward. And you're definitely moving forward with the Chariot card, right? The Chariot is also a major arcana card. The Chariot, by the way, is the personal Cancer card. You could be dealing with a Cancer. But the Chariot is a card of victory. The Chariot is all about moving forward and not looking back. It's one of the fastest cards in the deck. So once the two of you get acquainted, once the two of you understand that the two of you make a perfect couple, you're just, that's it, you're moving forward, right? And the last card that came out is the World. The World is my happy end card. This is one chapter of your life coming to an end, but a new, brand new, happy chapter of your life is about to begin. Wow, a very powerful, but at the same time, very positive and happy spread. Alright, Aries, see, I didn't even have to do as many clarifications as I usually do, but it's like one of the most important spreads I've seen for you in a long time, Aries. So you're ending this year very strongly, and with this new person, and that's it. This person is your lifetime partner, and your partner in crime, so to speak, figuratively speaking, I hope. But yeah. That's it, Aries. Really happy for you. Congratulations. Aries, if you are already married or if you're in a relationship, this spread is for you. We have the Two of Pentacles, clarified by the Ace of Swords. We have the Hierophant. We have the Nine of Cups. And we also have the Wheel of Fortune with the Eight of Wands on the bottom of the deck. It's a good spread. Some of you are thinking about going someplace, traveling on vacation. Some of you are already going. Others of you are planning a vacation, deciding between multiple destinations, or deciding if this is a good idea to travel this time of year, or travel right now, considering what's going on in the world right now. Others of you could be planning a wedding, and perhaps another group of you could be deciding between two different things that the two of you want to start at some point in the future. Perhaps you're starting to think of your New Year resolutions, right? The Two of Pentacles, the first card that came out, this is a card of a choice, a multiple choice. So like I said, some of you are deciding between different destinations where you want to go, different things you want to start together come New Year. You're just, in the space of trying to figure something out. But it's not anything bad. It's not anything negative. It's within your marriage or relationship. Some of you could be thinking about moving in together, by the way, or buying property, right? Or moving forward with something brand new. Speaking of something brand new, the Two of Pentacles is clarified by the Ace of Swords. The Ace of Swords could be a brand new beginning. The Ace of Swords, it could be a final decision. So after a long deliberation, the Ace of Swords is yes, we're going to do it, or yes, we're going to that particular destination, or yes, we're moving in, or yes, our wedding will take place on such and such date. You know, speaking of weddings, the Hierophant in the middle, that is your committed relationship or marriage card, or your future marriage card. Then we have the Nine of Cups. The Nine of Cups is a card of a wish come true, or this is a card of personal satisfaction or fulfillment. And the Wheel of Fortune with the Eight of Wands on the bottom of the deck all the way to your right. It could be, both cards could be travel cards, or both cards are moving forward cards, or starting a new chapter of your life cards. Overall, there's definitely something that's about to begin for you once you get through that Two of Pentacles energy. Once you're get on the same page with your significant other, that's when the rest of the spread will play out, starting with the Ace of Swords. But at some point during this period, during the next couple of weeks, you'll be, you know, making a decision. And once you've made up your mind, once you've made a decision, the rest of the spread will play out. It could be a new beginning, it could be a travel, moving in together, planning a wedding, and yada, yada, yada. All good stuff. All right? Cool. Let's see if anybody comes back from the past for you, Aries, the second half of December. Keep in mind, it could be somebody from a couple of months ago, a year ago, or a couple of years ago, so it doesn't have to be the most recent ex. Also, keep in mind, we are entering Venus retrograde on the 19th, but we usually start feeling the effects of it a few days prior to the actual date. So what that means is you may have more than one ex resurface. Right, so we got the Five of Swords clarified by the King of Pentacles. We have the Seven of Swords. We have the Nine of Swords clarified by the Four of Pentacles. And we also have the Ten of Swords on the bottom of the deck. You could be dealing with an Earth sign, Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn. Wow, Aries. So you are dealing with this King of Pentacles. It could be an Earth sign, Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn. If it's not an Earth sign, then it's somebody who doesn't make any sudden moves. Somebody who is very grounded, right? They could be working for a financial institution. So you'll just have to ask yourself one question, Aries. This person made you cry. This person put you through it. At some point in the past, this person cheated on you. They did all those bad things because that's the person you're dealing with here. So the question is, do you want to go through that again? If your answer is no, then move on, because this person has not changed. They are the same way they used to be back then when the two of you broke up. Speaking of the breakup, the Ten of Swords on the bottom of the deck all the way to your right, this is a card of an ending, an abrupt ending, right? So this is what happened between the two of you in the past, and this is what needs to happen between the two of you right now, before anything actually starts. Just, you need to shut it down, right? The first card that came out is the Five of Swords, is clarified by the King of Pentacles. The Five of Swords is a card of a breakup, an ugly breakup. This is a card of a fight that causes a breakup, right? This is a card of severing ties. This is when people slam doors into each other's faces on the way out. Then we have the Seven of Swords. The Seven of Swords is a card of a deception, it's a card of a cheater, it's a card of a thief, it's a card of somebody who is up to no good. And then we have the Nine of Swords, clarified by the Four of Pentacles. The Nine of Swords is a card of somebody who is crying during the night, somebody who can't sleep, somebody who is stressed out, somebody who's got anxieties and depression. And I think that was you when the two of you broke up. So if you wanna go through it again, go ahead, give him a second chance. If you don't, then move on, right? If you don't want to do it, then the Four of Pentacles clarifying the Nine of Swords is what you need to do. You need to hold back, you need to not open up, and just shut it down with that Ten of Swords on the bottom of the deck. Alright, so yeah, unfortunately we have to end on this note. It kind of reminds me of my beware readings I do once a month. So beware of this King of Pentacles. Be very, very aware. Okay? But that's what I got for you for this time period, Aries. If this video resonates with you, please like it. Please also share and subscribe. And other than that, Aries, have an amazing second half of December. And there you have it. This was your tarot reading for this time period. I hope it resonated with you and helps you live a better life one way or the other. Thank you for watching, sharing, and subscribing.